everybody. This is Chad with Round 2. We're here for our January 2022 Product Spotlight video. So Happy New Year to everybody. 2021 was a great year. We talked about it in the December video, a ton of cool stuff that was coming out. We've got a lot of stuff in January. The year starting off really good. So we're sitting out here. We're in the warehouse right now. Our New York Toy Fair booth is going to be going up here so we can mock it up. We'll be doing some videos coming out next month with a lot of other cool new stuff that's coming out, new tooling for this year. But for now, we're gonna jump in, show you guys the product that's on the way for January. So in this video, we've got 6/1/18 scale cars from Auto World, diecast. We got some 1/6 scale diecast bikes from AMT we're gonna show you guys. We've got new 1/64 scale, an Auto World release, and a Johnny Lightning Street Freaks release that we're going to show you. And then for model kits, there's 7 new model kits, some sci-fi stuff, some automotive stuff, and a model kit accessory. So we're gonna jump right into it. We're gonna start with 1/64. All right, so jumping right into 1/64 scale, we're gonna start with Auto World. This is 2021 release 5, so actually the final release for 2021 hitting here. We've got 6 cars in this, 2 colors of each that we're gonna show, starting off with the square bodies for this release, the 1985 Chevy Silverado 10 fleet side. First version A here is in dark blue, two-tone with the white along the sides and the white top. And great detailing on that one. Second is in light tan, has a brown two-tone and a little bit of orange striping in it as well. Really, really awesome looking for there. You got tan interior on it, with some white line tires and great looking wheels on that one too. And next up, the 1966 Chevy Suburban version A here is in gray, has a tan top on it. Good looking detailing on that one. And the Suburbans have proven to be a very popular release. Second here is in this dark blue color, also has an off-white tannish white top on it. The off-white bumpers look great on there as well to complement it, and has blue color matched wheels inside. Third in the release, heavy with the Chevy trucks on this one, the 2020 Chevy Silverado ZL1 LT Trail Boss. First version is in this bright orange color, really cool color for that new truck there. Has some black wheels on it, and the second version is all blacked out, black wheels, black paint, a lot of great trim packaging on here. You can see all the little details for the badging. Of course, the front end looks great on it, and another awesome release for that. Next up, these have proven to be great sellers, the 2018 Dodge Challenger Hellcat. First one here in red, black wheels on that. Of course, that those Hellcat real chunky wheels on it. It's looks awesome in that red color there. And next for this Hellcat release, gloss white. Really brings out all the details on it. You can see the vents on the hood. Again, those big knobby tires, black spoiler, and all those Hellcat details along with it. Fifth in the release, this is the third time we've released this newer casting, the 1995 Toyota Supra. These have been doing really well. You guys are really loving them. First one here is in blue. This is a Baltic blue color. Might look a little black on the camera. It's a really cool dark blue color. And Renaissance red, which is more of a darker burgundy red color with black interior on that one. So we did do it in the brighter red before. This is that darker Renaissance red. And of course, does have the spoilers on this release as well. Next up, 1970 Dodge Challenger TA. First version is in green here. Has the striping along the sides of it, the black hood, all those great TA details along it. It's got white letter tires on it as well. Second version is in banana yellow. And again, with all the black detailing, that really complements that bright yellow and tones it down, makes it look extra mean. So that's everything for the regular Auto World release. We do have a straight pack Auto World trailer as well. So we talked about a couple months ago, we did the 1/18 scale of this patriotic trailer. They've proven to be very popular, so we did bring it in 1/64 scale with the Lady Liberty. You can see on the side there, it's got the eagle on the back, chrome trim on it, and it does open up so you can put your Auto World cars inside. It is true 1/64 scale, like all of our Auto World cars are. Then next in the release, we do have new stuff for Johnny Lightning in Street Freaks. So we're gonna jump into that. Same thing with the Street Freaks. 6 cars in that, 2 color variations each, 12 total. Starting off with the 1981 Chevy Silverado 10 fleet side. These Silverado Zingers have been flying off the shelves. Really, everything we do square body flies off the shelves. These ones are awesome. First one here is in the purple with this green flames down the side of it. Looks really great with that chrome engine, red line tires on it. And the second one in orange with the green flames down the side. Great looking illustrations of it on the packaging or on the cards that do come in all of our Street Freaks releases. Next up, the 1973 Plymouth Roadrunner. Another new zinger for Johnny Lightning here, and a great looking one. First in this great looking lime green color, lime green metallic. It really pops. I don't know if you can see it on camera, but in the light, that color looks awesome. The red line tires look great with the green chrome engine side pipes. Really cool looking release. And then we've got orange for the next variation here. Got the Hemi striping on the side of it. Again, the big chrome blown engine and the red line tires on that one as well. Next up is for our Import Heat sub-series of Street Freaks. So this is the 1963 MG MGB. So some really cool things about this release. It's kind of done up as an autocross car or a track car, and we actually did this. There is a Johnny Lightning Club out in Lincoln, Rhode Island, called the Lincoln Johnny Lightning Race Club. We did this one kind of as a car for them. So Jeremy Morin does run it. We actually have his name on there as a little Easter egg. And this has the Racer's Edge tires on it as well. So that club does do track racing, and those plastic Racer's Edge tires are great for track racing. So we thought we'd do a fun little race MG. First one in red there with the striping on it. Second in this light blue color. Has two-tone darker blue and white striping on that one as well. And just really fun to bring this MG casting back out and in a way that people can race it like they do with the real MGs. So next up, Demolition Derby. The return of the custom Holland hearse. First one here is in flat pink. It's really cool looking for this release. Has the death on two legs on the side of it and these little flowers on it. Ramming speed for the name on the card there. And super cool looking detail with all those little flowers. Rubber tires on this one. Second one is in this light green color. More of a light teal, I suppose. Again, with the flowers on it. Reverse in pieces on the name for this car. And it's fun to have some fun with this this Holland Hearst casting. So we're doing some other fun stuff with this Holland Hearst that you guys will see coming out soon. So next up in the release, Blacked Out, fifth in the release. This is the 1947 Willys pickup. This one has only been released a handful of times. I think maybe this is like the third time we've done this one. Not a very common one, and it's such a cool casting. I can't believe it hasn't been used more. So first one with this Blacked Out, it says Witching Hour, has Nevermore on the side of it. Really, really cool details on this gasser. Looks super mean. And you can see the tonneau cover on the back has that big evil looking skull face. First one being in black with blue. And the second variation is a two-tone. It's a gloss black on the side, kind of a flat black or flat gunmetal on the top there. And it has red details, red interior. Just a mean looking car, and these should do really well. Lastly is spoilers, and this one I think is a super cool spoiler. This is the 1971 Ford Pinto. So in the spoiler series, we always have the numbers on the side. This one, number 58, we always have that engine sticking out of the top. But some of the really cool details about this one, first one in gunmetal with the striping along the side, we put these real thick drag racing tires on the back of it. So you can see that they're real fat looking on the back there, and they're really wide. Looks so cool on that Pinto. You see so many of those Pintos done up like drag cars. So the first version looks great in gunmetal. Second version is a bright yellow color. It's a really great contrast to the to version A. And again, with the black striping down it, big Ford decal, and those big meaty knobby tires on the back. So that's everything we've got for 164th. Next, we're going to jump in and show you guys the large-scale diecast. All right, so starting off in 1/18 scale, we're going to start with the real old classic car, 1935 Auburn 851 Speedster here in butternut yellow. So we've done a few of these Auburns. We've done the Speedsters, Speedster SSJs, A lot of different color variations. This one looks great. That butternut yellow really looks awesome on that car with the big long front end. Of course, those pipes coming out the side of it. And the interior with that red complements it so well. It has the red pinstriping along the side too. That really makes that interior look great. And a lot of awesome details in the gauges, the wheel. Just really, really cool looking for this one. So this has opening doors and hood on it. Detailed engine, steerable front wheels. Really great accuracy. You can see some of the chassis details along on the bottom there. And look at the back. You can see all the information here about that 35 Speedster. Again, these have been a lot of fun doing these 1930s era cars, some of these older era cars. And you guys have really been enjoying them, so we're going to keep them coming. So next up, jumping up to the 1970s, we've got the Plymouth AAR Cuda in fire blue. Really cool looking one for this. There's some pretty cool options with this one. Comes with extra hood clips in the packaging. Of course, super detailed. The interior looks awesome in this one as well. You can see all the details, kind of orange around the gauges, a little wood, the wood grain around the steering wheel, that brown color around the steering wheel, the rest of the interior being black. Really looks great in this. Has opening doors, hood, and trunk on this model. The detailed engine, of course, steerable front wheels, and great accuracy on that one as well. And a look at the back, some of those awesome looking illustrations done by Mike G here. Next up, we're going to jump back into a 1955 Chevy Bel Air convertible. Very interesting car for this one. Really cool looking. It is this pale yellow color with this two-tone like teal green interior on it. It's a super unique combination, an OEM combination for this car, but very rare. One of these rolled through auction, I believe, last year and just went for a crazy price. A super interesting car. I think the colors look awesome together. Everybody might have mixed opinions, but there's no doubting that this is a super rare combination, sold for a lot of money, and is just something that you would never see a manufacturer do today. Love it. So this one has opening doors and hood as well. Of course, the detailed engine, the steerable front wheels, all that stuff that you come to expect. And a look at the back of that packaging with some more information on that 55 Bel Air convertible. Next up, for our muscle car and Corvette Nationals, we've talked a lot about the program that we've done here. We've done, I think, like over 50 cars that have been muscle car and Corvette Nationals releases. This one is super cool. The 1969 Oldsmobile Cutlass SW31. We did some pretty cool stuff with this one. It has a newly tooled front grille. The hubcaps are new. This green color looks amazing on it. This car was actually, the real car was at Muscle Car and Corvette Nationals twice. In 2015, it was there under their barn finds category, where they have cars that need to be restored or were found. And then the car was rebuilt and featured again. And you can see it here, owned by Ryan Weaver, some of the photos from the show. A cool car with a great story, and one that we're very, very proud to replicate. We thank Ryan and all the people at Muscle Car and Corvette Nationals for letting us do these releases. Next up, the 1967 Shelby GT350 here in Wimbledon White. Really great looking release for this one as well. Has these kind of copper, light copper stripes that go along the roof of it. That looks really awesome with that Wimbledon white color. You've got the interior is black on this one, opening doors and hood on this one as well with that detailed engine. And a look here at the back of the packaging. That illustration and all that information on the back. Lastly, for the cars that we've got for you guys in the diecast, the 1969 Baldwin Motion Chevelle Phase 3. I really love this car. There's like, oh, that black color, super, super dark gloss black color on this that looks awesome. Has all the SS detailing on the side of it, all the badges, the Baldwin Motion detailing on it. It's got Mickey Thompson white letter tires that look awesome on this, especially with that black paint. It's just such a mean looking car. Opening doors, hood, and trunk on this model. Steerable front wheels, detailed engine, all of that great stuff. And a look there at the back of the packaging. And then also in Diecast, we've got something different for you guys this month. We've been talking about these for a while. We mentioned them even at the beginning of the year that they were coming out. These are under AMT, the 1/6 scale Schwinn Stingray bikes. So these are super cool. You guys have been clamoring about them. We're so happy to bring them out. The first one here is the orange crate. So you can see it in orange with all these detailing. This is under AMT, where we did a lot of our other Schwinn stuff under model kits, but these are die-cast metal. Of course, fully detailed, already put together, and just looks so cool. These bikes have been commanding so much money these days, and it's just such a great throwback item, and we're really happy to bring these out. So we've got the orange crate here. You can see, look at all those chrome parts and all those details and the stick shift on it, and then the apple crate coming out as well in that red color. You can see all that chrome detailing on there. And again, the stick shift, just great looking. So we have these two, are the first two coming out. There will be other color variations. Of course, there are so many great colors that these crate bikes were made in. So we will have more coming out soon. That's everything we've got for this large scale diecast stuff. We're gonna jump in and show you model kits next. So starting off with model kits, we do have one accessory one that we want to show you guys. This was actually in the background of the video last month, and we forgot to get around to it. Some of you called us out on it. So here's the look. The Custom and Competition Spokes and Stripes Wheels and Tires Accessory Kit. So these will be coming out soon, about to hit shelves. These got these classic five-spoke mags here in chrome. What's really cool about it, these tires pinstripe their red line and gold line tires at the bottom. So you can see the gold line. If you flip them over, they are red line on the other side. So a really cool custom option for your kits if you want to change up the wheels. And there's a look at the back of the packaging there. Just calling out some of our new kits and lots of cool stuff that you can put these on. So more accessories to come throughout the year. We're going to jump into the car kits now, starting off with the Tommy Evo. This is the new rear engine AA fueler. So what's cool about this one, we've retooled a lot of the body parts on this to bring it back out. It's an original art release, so it actually comes with a mini print in the package, which is really neat. We did improve the decal sheet on this from its previous release, pre-lettered slicks it comes with, and of course kept that vintage style packaging. You can get a look at some of the details that are on this kit here. That big spoiler on it, how the body shell is, the wheelbase. You can see all the chassis details here. And there's another look at how you can build it up, and a little bit about Tommy Evo here on the side. And then on the back, you can look at that parts tree there. See those new body pieces, retooled body pieces, and the decal sheet that's coming along with it. So that's a super cool one. Another one, this is a super unique kit. It's not been out in a very, very long time. The Californian luxury sports car. So this kit commands a pretty high price on the secondary market. It's a really neat old MPC kit based on an Olds Toronado. So really, really neat features in this kit. It has pad printed tires, expanded decal sheet on it. Of course, the vintage style packaging here. And just to give you a look at some of the, look at all that crazy wild custom stuff that you can do with this kit. That custom front end, giant hood scoops, exhaust pipes, that two-piece cantilevered rear spoiler, bucket seats. It's a front-wheel drive engine setup being based on that Toronado as a base for the kit. The four white wall tires, and there is a look at that parts tree on the back with all those parts and pieces. So really awesome old show car kit that we're happy to bring back out. Next up, we've got our funny car, the Chevy 2. This is a 427 fuel-injected drag car, of course, 1/25 scale. This is original tooling. We did do the Chevy 2 wagon recently. That was a new tool. This is original tooling. New decal sheet on this with a bunch of different options on it. Vintage-style packaging on it. Kind of just that art packaging without all the details on the front. So it looks great even if you just display the box. There's a look at some of the features on this car. And on the side. And then on the back, you can see all the parts for that. The 427, all those body pieces. Of course, that big decal sheet. There's a lot of options there of that decal sheet. And just great looking release for that. Now jumping into, we got a lot of really unique stuff in model kits. So we're really excited to show you some of these. This one, I love. I'm a big van guy. This is a Chevy custom van, the Foxy Box kit. So this is just too cool. I mean, it's got a ton of custom accessories with it. Tires and wheels. We've expanded the decal sheet on it. Has vintage style packaging as well. And some of the custom options that come with it are just too great. I'll show you here on the side. You can see that custom front end cap that's on it. It's got twin skylights. It's got a big spoiler on the back. These louvered portholes, and there's a couple different portholes that come with it. Jacked up suspension, CB radio, air horn, side exit exhaust. Just such an awesome kit here. And you can see an example with these extra louvers. It almost looks like an old spaceship or something. Just such a cool custom van for that one. And you can see here all that big parts tree and all the decals, the big Foxy Box stuff. Great looking kit. Next up, one more for the Chevys, the Monte Carlo Super Stocker kit. Another really cool looking kit, and these Super Stockers have been doing really well. I love the box art on this MPC kit. It just looks so cool. It looks so rad. There's a lot of neat stuff in this kit as well. Pad printed tires on it, expanded decal sheets on this as well, with that vintage style packaging look with the illustration on there. You can get a look here at that expanded decal sheet to see all those different options that you can put on your race car. There's even little MPC and Auto Worlds hidden in there that you can throw on. We got bonus pad printed vinyl tires on here. There's a look at it all built out. Look at all those cool options and details that come with it. You can see the net and the custom cage and the wheels, and then a look here at that parts tree on the back. And then lastly, for the Automotive S kits, then we'll jump into the sci-fi kit we got. This is another wild one, the Rupp Super Snow Sport, the world's first dragster snowmobile in a supersize 1/20th scale. I love this kit. This is such a wild, almost death trap of a machine. It is just too cool. This comes with a color display on here, expanded decal sheet, PVC driver, seat and tracks, vintage style packaging, and that is just such a wild thing with that snowmobile. You can see on the motor here, 302 cubic inch engine shoved onto the front of that, probably no more than 2 feet from the driver. And that big dragster style body. I can't imagine driving this thing. I wouldn't think you'd get too cold with that 302 blowing all that hot air right into your face. And there's a look here at some of the other pieces and parts to put this kit together. Perfect timing for all the snow that we've been starting to get up here in Indiana. And there's a look at the back of the parts tree for that one. That's everything automotive. Lastly, we've got a sci-fi kit for you guys. This is a neat one for Star Trek, one that people have been waiting for us to bring back out, the USS Enterprise bridge set. So some of the cool stuff about this is very similar to when the bridge set was brought out about 10 years ago. Back then, we did a lot of stuff to make the tooling better, to make the bridge area bigger. There's a ton of decals in this for all of the all the command centers and screens. I mean, a ton of decals that are on this to really build it out the way you want. It comes with characters on there. You can see there are 6 bodies, 10 different heads for multiple characters. We've got pictures of the characters here. So when you're building it out and you figure out how you want to decorate your character, make it look more like the series. But we did update the box on this to give you a better look at how you want to build it out and how you want to do it. So it's got a lot more pictures and reference for you to know when you build out this bridge set. So another great example here. More movie screens on the side, so you don't necessarily have to do as much work trying to go through every episode and figure out how to put it all together. But again, just super fun. I know you Star Trek guys have been really love building these kits, and we're happy to bring this one back out. So got a lot more stuff coming in Star Trek and other sci-fi options coming out. So that is everything for January. As I mentioned before, we're going to be putting some more videos together this month that'll probably come out in February, talking about all the new tooling we got coming out, all the cool new stuff that we're doing this year. Again, we post all of that on our on round2corp.com. There's a new tooling section. There's a news section. You can see what we've been up to. You can follow us on all of our Facebook pages that I'll post down below, on all of our Instagram pages that I'll post down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, subscribe so you get notified when we put all these videos out. Thank you guys again. Thanks for a great 2021. Thanks for what's going to be a great 2022. See you in February.